In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Today is the fourth Sunday of the blessed month of Misra. As we approach the end of the Coptic year, the Church always, in the fourth Sunday of the month of Misra, as well as next week, the only Sunday in the month of Nisan, the Church read for us about the end of the world and the Judgment Day. So the Gospel today, from the Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 13, from verse 3 to verse 37. Next week, the Gospel from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 24, almost the whole chapter. And both of them about the end of the world, the signs, and the Judgment Day. At the beginning of the Gospel today, the disciples asked our Lord Jesus Christ, when you are going to come, and what are the signs of your second coming? And we notice from the answer of our Lord Jesus Christ that he did not respond and did not answer the first part of the questions about when you are going to come, but he took in more details about the signs of his second coming. And he mentioned 14 signs it will precede his second coming to judge all the living and the dead, and to have the final judgment day. And if you listen carefully to the end of the Gospel today, from verse 35 to verse 37, the Lord said, watch therefore, for you do not know when the master of the house is coming. In the evening, at midnight, at the crown of the rooster, or in the morning, lest coming suddenly he find you sleeping. And what I say to you, I say to all, watch. Be ready, watch. So this is the main reason why our Lord Jesus Christ did not give an answer to the time of his second coming. To be ready for, to watch. And when he said watch, and then he looked to the disciples and said watch. And then he looked to those around him and said, whatever I say to you, I say to all, watch. Less than some people will think that he took only for the disciples. Yes, sometimes he took only for the disciples and gave them assignments. Like Matthew in St. Matthew 28:19, he say, go therefore, baptize all nation in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This assignment only for the disciples and their successors. But to be ready for the second coming of the Lord and to watch, this is for everyone. So he said, watch. What I say to you, I say to all, watch. And he still say that today for us, I say to you, watch. So we have to be ready, and we have to watch. Saint Anthony the Great thought about the depths of the Judgment Day. And then he started to ask some questions with little bit loud voice between himself as he talked to God. He asked some question to the Lord. He said, Lord, how is it that some die when they are very young, while others drag on to extreme old age. ده في ناس بتموت صغيرين وناس لسه عايشين كبار جدا وعواجيز. سؤال وبيفكر في الجادجمنت داي. Another question. Why are these some people who are very poor and some people who are very rich? Why? He asked another question. Why do wicked men prosper and why are the just is in need? And frankly speaking, the question that St. Anthony the Great asked, many of us asked, and this is in our mind, why? And listen carefully to the answer. He heard a voice from heaven answering him, Anthony, keep your attention on yourself. ركز في نفسك, مالكش دعوة. Keep your attention on yourself. These things are according to the judgment of God. And it is not in your advantage to know anything about it. This answer for all of us. You think about the judgment day, keep focus on yourself. Are you ready for the second coming? Are you watch? And God will put all this in consideration when he's going to judge all of us. To Saint Anthony, listen carefully to what the Lord said to him and apply it in his daily life. And the question today, how can we be ready? How can we be ready for the judgment day? How can we be ready to be able to inherit the eternal life? Watch and be ready. The answer is number one, to believe in Jesus. Accept him as our own Savior. Live according to his commandments. Do the right things. In other words, live with the Lord while we still live in the world. At the end of the day, at the end of our life, at the end of the world, on the judgment day, if we were with the Lord, personal relationship with him, then we are going to be with him forever in eternal life. I'm going to share with you just 10 points quickly, and each one supported with one verse from the Bible to see how the Bible directs us to be ready for the judgment day as we approach the end of the year, the Coptic year. Number one, we have to be concerned with the heavenly things, not with the earthly matters. As we assume that we love to go to heaven to be with the Lord forever after the judgment day, while we still live on earth, we have to think about whatever is above, if this is our destination. So St. Paul said in Colossians chapter 3, verse 1, if then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of the Father. Look at the bosom of the Father, and our Lord Jesus Christ sit on the throne. And the meaning of the right hand of the Father, because God the Father, as we said many times before, have no right or left. God is a spirit. God the Son, who incarnate and took our flesh, when he ascended to heaven, he took us with him, was ascended with a glorified body, and set us in his right hand. This is what St. John Chrysostom said. On the day of the Ascension, he gave a sermon, wonderful sermon, and said, today we celebrate the feast day of the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, who took us and set us in his right. So if we really want to go to heaven, we have to think about whatever is above, not whatever on the earth. This is number one. Number two, we have to live a pure life. Purity. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, be holy as your Father who art in heaven is holy. St. John in his first epistle, chapter 2, verse 3, and he said, and in everyone who has this hope in him, in Christ, purifies himself just as he is pure. We have to live a holy life. We cannot have unholy life. We have to live according to God's commandment. Be holy, as your Father who art in heaven is holy. Number one, think whatever is above. Number two, live the pure life. Number three, we have to read the Bible, know the Word of God by heart. We have to attend the church regularly. We have to fast, we have to practice all this spiritual, because it leads us to be close to God, to know God more, to bind with Him. Reading the Bible, apply it in our daily life, this is something essential. It is not option. By the way, we have to know everything in the Bible, because God revealed himself to us through the Holy Bible. And by the way, he did not reveal everything about himself. But whoever, whatever he revealed in the Bible is sufficient enough for our salvation. So at least we have to know whatever written in the Bible. Because over there, when we go to heaven, he's going to reveal us more and more as we'll be able to absorb when we are in the glorified body. St. Paul said in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as in a manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. When we are close to the final day or the judgment day, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, the gathering together, come to the church regularly. It's not the matter of once in a while. Regularly, we read the Bible. Regularly, we exhort one another. This is preaching and teaching. Especially when we approach. And we don't know, as we say in the beginning, when the Lord is going to come, but I may go today, or you may go today or tomorrow. So whatever, it comes first. You have to be ready. Number four, not only attend the church regularly, which is important, but be ready for the Holy Communion and receive the Holy Communion regularly. This is a big difference between that we assemble together in the Vespers or any Bible study to pray and to read the Bible and to exhort one another. And when we come to the Divine Liturgy, the main purpose is to be ready and receive communion. And we are going to talk about the next point about communion and receiving communion. This is something essential. It is not just an option, because, and this is, I would like to approach number five, be ready for the communion and receive the communion. Be ready for the communion. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, verily, verily, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in me. This is in John chapter 6, verse 53. And in the rest of the chapter 6, he talk and repeat again about Holy Communion and how important it is. Whoever eat my body and drink my blood, My blood abide in me and I abide in him. Some people sometimes they don't receive communion. And some people they receive it once in a while. And we advise to receive communion as often as we can, but number five, we have to be ready for the communion. Because if you just receive communion and you are not ready, then you add more sin to yourself or to myself. This is why the Bible said, be ready for the communion. To be ready for the communion, we have to repent. We have to live the life of repentance. The Bible said clearly in Luke chapter 13, verse 31, unless you repent, all you be perish. إِن لَمْ تَتُوبُوا فَإِنَّ جَمِيعَكُمْ هَكَذَا تَهْلَكُونَ Unless you repent, all you will be perish. We are against the idea of everyone receive communion as if he eat and drink just regular food. Or someone abstain from communion because in Egypt they used to say المناولة يا أبونا نور ونار هما دول اللي حافظين نور ونار طب ما تاخذوا النور ف I'm not going to receive communion because المناولة نور ونار I'm not ready ممكن تحرقني فعلا Saint Paul said if anyone receive communion and he is unworthy then he is crime he made crime against God and then he said in 1 Corinthians this is why many of you are sick and many of you fallen asleep حتى بيموتوا but to receive communion yes to be ready to receive communion is very important unless you repent, all you will be perish. This is number four. Number six, we have to love one another. First, we have to love God. يعني to be able to ask whatever is above more than whatever on the earth, number one, to be able to live a pure life, to be able to attend the church regularly, to receive communion, to be ready of the communion. All this need to love God. Love God from all your heart, your mind, and your strength, which is very important as the commandment said to us. And as a result of our love to God, we have to love one another. Natural result. When we love God, it is easy to love one another, even to love our enemies. So number six, love one another after we show our love to God. It's very clear in the First Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 12. And may the Lord make you increase and abide in love one another and to all just as we do to you. St. Paul said, we loved you. And we want you to love one another and to all. When you say love one another, maybe one another in the church, in the family, on those who are in common with you in belief and faith. And then he said to all, even to the enemies and those who are in disagreement. We are not like the other people who hate those who don't agree with them. Call them infidel. Kill them. Because just because he did not in agreement with him, he gave himself the right to do so. For us, love God, love one another, and love everyone. Love all, even your enemies. Number seven, we have to comfort one another. If we really know all this, so we have to comfort one another. Then I said, you know what? Today, Sunday, the last Sunday of the month of Misra, next week, the Coptic year, close to the end, we are going to start a new one. We have to be ready, comfort one another. Like suppose some people did not attend the church today. You may go and call them and say, you know what, today gospel was about so and so. Comfort one another with this word. Exactly what the Bible said. Also in the First Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 18. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Don't underestimate the power and the effect of the word of God. Maybe one verse, one passage from the Bible, it can change the life of the person. Remember what the Lord said in the Sermon on the Mount, you have been clean because of the word that I have spoken to you. Number 8, go along with this, comfort one another, share the word of God with one another. It's not only the matter to read the Bible, it's not only the matter that you try to apply the Bible in your daily life, which is essential, but also we have to share the word of God with one another. With one another in the level of preaching and teaching, one another when we have Bible study at home or within the groups, one another with your wife or your husband or the children, friends, one another, if we really love the word of God and we are filled with the Spirit, it's naturally, we are going, some people, when you sit down with them, because they read the Bible more often. One statement, and then he mentioned one verse. Another statement, he said, you know what the Bible said, what the Lord said, what St. Mark said, what St. While some other people don't associate with the Bible at all, you find out that what they talk and what they say had nothing to do with Christianity at all. Even the vocabularies that they used, like the other people live in the world and the world live in them. Yes, we live in the world, but we should not allow the world live in us. St. Paul in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 21, he said, preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and teachings. And here St. Paul talked to a bishop of Ephesus. He ordained him as a bishop and let him take care of Ephesus. And then he sent the letters to follow up with him. You as a bishop, the first duty to preach and to exhort, But even with the bishop, he said to him, with all long suffering. It's not just to say, unless you repent, all your people perish, and that's it. We have to explain, with all long suffering. But even in our level, like we have over 70 Sunday school teachers, we have over 70 deacons, and they teach one another. When we have the in Mahargani Kraza, I was very delighted to see our deacon in high school teach the deacons in elementary and junior high. And of course, all of them under the direction of the old deacon teach one another. Share the good news with one another. Number 9, we should not judge one another. If we really would like to go to heaven, we should not judge one another. Leave the judgment in God's hand. You see, when St. Anthony just have some questions, why there are some rich, some poor, some wicked, some and the wicked are in prosperity, and the just people are not. Don't judge one another. It is not up to us. God is a judge. In the Sermon on the Mountain, Chapter 7, verse 1, judge not to be judged. Also, St. Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 5, therefore, judge nothing before the time until the Lord comes, who will both bring the light in the hidden things of darkness and reveal the counsel of the hearts. then each one prays will come from the Lord. And also each judgment will come from the Lord. I will never forget the story of the monk in the monastery who is to live. And most of the other monks think that he is not serious enough. Sometimes he came late in the church, sometimes he don't attend the prayer from the beginning. In their eyes, yeah, he is not fit to go to heaven. So when he became very old, he felt that he's going to go. He gathered all the monks and said, "My brothers and my fathers, pray for me, I will pray for you. I feel that I'm going to go very soon. And I feel, thank God, I'm going to go to heaven." So they look at each other, and تعرفين الضحكة الصفرة اللي ساعات الناس بتعملها, بصوا لبعض كده. دوت this أبونا. فهيل نوت ذات said what? What's going on? Said أبونا frankly speaking that we feel that you are not ready and you say you are going to go to heaven. Said yes. Sometimes أبونا you come late in the church. No. They don't know what he's doing at his cell, you know. He said, yes, I am weak. I did some mistakes, but I repent. But let me ask you a question. Did you ever see me judge any one of you for all my life? They look at each other and said, no, Abuna, in this you are perfect. We never witness or see you judge any one of us. It's okay. I'm going to go to heaven, and when the Lord is going to start to judge me, I said, can I say something? I said, go ahead. Then I will say, your Lord, you said, judge not to be judged. I did not judge anyone in my life. Then don't judge me. I will enter to heaven. And of course, to reach that level, to be able not to judge one another or to judge other people, this is a very high spiritual level. Must do all God's commandments to be able to reach, judge not to be judged. Finally, be patient. This is number 10, be patient. Be patient to do all what we mentioned and be patient in our life because we need it. We need it. St. James said in his epistle, chapter 5, verse 8, you also be patient, establish your heart, for the coming of the Lord is at hand. For the coming of the Lord is at hand. Either I'm going to go or he is going to come is at hand. Be patient. I heard one time in the Moody Bible radio, someone said, Lord, make me patient, give me patience, and give it to me now. He don't have patience even to receive patience. Be patient. Be patient in our relationship with the Lord when he allow us to have some troubles or some tribulations. Be patient when in our relationship with one another. الناس مش مستحملة بعض. What is going on? Be patient. Because if we got angry or upset or we became nervous, we cannot make the right decision. Be patient. You also be patient, establish your heart for the coming of the Lord is at hand. This is just some of the points how we can be ready to the judgment day of the Lord, will be able to have the praise. Come to me, sit in my right hand. So may God give us to be ready and to benefit from the word of God applied in our daily life. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.